This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, email marketing is done. Is there anything else we did it after the email marketing? If you people remember.
Landing page.
Yes, very good. So that was a landing page. Thank you, Alia. Fine, today we are going to start with the social media apps. So which is the trending social media apps and you people are very familiar with? So can you people list me out?
Instagram.
Okay. Is it only Instagram? Yes, I got it from Facebook also. Okay, very good. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. Still Snapchat, Pinterest. Good, very good. Is it only this many apps? LinkedIn, very, very good. Okay, so I think most of them are repetitive. That means everyone are okay, hike. That's also very good. Fine. So whether we are using all these apps only for the entertainment purpose or is it for anything we are going to get more than the entertainment? So which is very professionally we can use it, which is that app which can be considered as a professional use? LinkedIn, very good. Is it only LinkedIn? That's very nice. Okay, so my next question is, which is that social media app you can be able to refer it for the purpose of buying any goods? Is that you are going to refer with the YouTube and Instagram and Facebook? Amazon, very good. Quicker. Okay, so thank you very much for everyone who have been responded. And I do not want any particular people are going to respond it. I hope almost of the people are responding it, but let it be the full strength are going to respond to it. Okay, so that shows that everyone are awake even this evening time. Okay, thank you all once again. Yes, so the list of social apps what you have been specified, yes, these are the apps which we are going to use it. So when you are going to use it for the personal reasons, so it will be only with the entertainment. So where you can be able to share your views on any particular subject, or it could be of your personal, or it could be general issues. Okay, so where the same social media apps can be used for the purpose of businesses. Okay, so let's see how we can be able to use this social media with any of the business account we can be created or not. Before starting with that, is that anyone is using out of this listed social media apps, anyone are using with any business account? So the people who are not using, type it as no. Okay. The people who are using, please let me know on which platform. Good. That's very good. Thanks for your suggestions, Nikita and other friends. Good. So now, let me know that, is that anyone who is running any of the type of business of their own, or it could be of their family, or it could be of their relations, is that you have been part of the business activities? Is there anyone who is doing a business? Yes, Durga Jain. Can I know what is that business, Durga?
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah. Go ahead.
So I basically crochet tops and I sell them, so it's kind of fashion related, I guess.
Okay. Is that you are going to do it on online or is it going to be on offline? That you, do you have any place where you are selling this product?
So at least till I finish college, I'm going to be doing it online. Maybe
okay.
Later I'll think about opening an offline store, but for right now it's completely online.
Okay. Is that you are going? Do you have a connection with the direct wholesalers, or you are just referring it with some of the website, like how we have a Meesho? So where the people who are the sellers will be someone else, and you will be the mediator where you will be selling it, and you'll be taking the kind of commissions. Is it like that, or do you have your own connections directly?
I have my own connections directly, sir, and that's why I took this course, so that I can have my own website and
definitely.
Basically do it on my own.
Definitely. So all the very best for your future plans, and many of the others also who have not said also, but if they are doing it, all the very best. But definitely this will help you out. So that was the reason why I asked you people whether are you running with any business, so that we can directly implement this whatever we are learnings is happening, so you can be able to implement it. Good, fine then. So let's see that whenever you are going to do the business, you will be having a two choices. So how do you want to target your customers or target your business? So who is your main target? So there are two types of business people. So one is B2B and B2C. So B2B stands for anyone has an idea?
Business to business, sir.
Good. Then B2C stands for?
Business to consumer.
Very good. So in these two options, which is your option? Is that you are going to target the people who are into a business, that is like a wholesalers or with the retailers, or do you want to target the people who are going to be a user of that product? Okay. So now, if you are going to think like a B2B, so there are particular platform where you can be able to get more business to business people. So whereas when you are going to think on business to consumer, you have the other platform where you can be able to concentrate on those things. Okay. So whatever we have listed out the social media apps, it is not only those apps are available. There are a lot of business apps are available, but these are all the familiar apps which we are going to use it, and we can be able to globally get connected with this. Okay, so now today the topic what we are going to start with is Facebook marketing. So as you all know that the history of the Facebook, who is the founder of it and from when it has been started with. Okay, so you will be having an idea on that. Who is the founder of it? Nikita, I have not shared the screen, so still I have not been. Okay. So do you have an idea who is the founder of Facebook? Very good.
Mark.
Yes, Mark. So as you all know that what is the intention of this? So actually, if you see that the Facebook was being started for the purpose of using it as a communicator between the students. So like how we had a kind of a slam book concept in our college days, so where you are doing it right now. So it was just a communicator between the student to student. So it was being introduced only with a particular university. Later on, it became so much familiar with the students, and it was being introduced to get connected with the one university students to another university students. So that became as a common connectivity between the students of different universities. Then later on, then it became very much socialized, and the people were happy with its services. Like before, we had a lot of other apps where later on, when the Facebook become familiar, so that those apps were been they were not continued with their services. They stopped their services. So in that, Orkut was one of the competitors at that time. Later on, the Facebook became very familiar with, and it has been continued its legacy. Okay, so let's not go in deep on those history of that. So what is our requirement? So how it is going to be helpful from the Facebook to us? So when you are going to create a Facebook account, or it could be any social media account, is it going to ask you with any of your credit card details, or with your address proof, or any such kind of informations? Or is it asking you to pay some money and create an account? No. So why it is going to give a free service to the people? So what is that it is going to gain it out of it? So if you take an example of Facebook, what it is going to gain it? Many are not going to pay anything. And anyway, it is not a government product also, so that they are going to get some subsidies and they are going to earn the money out of it. So how it is going to be beneficial for companies like this? People's data, exactly. Okay, so when you are going to open an account, you are not going to just give some username and password. You are also going to give some information like, what do you like it? What do you like most? And what is that activity you are doing it on that platform? So all these things, it is going to be recorded by the particular companies. Okay, either it could be a Google, or it could be a Facebook, or it could be in LinkedIn, or it could be a Twitter. So any of these people who are going to allow you to create an account at free of cost, and they are going to take the data. It's not an anything hidden, it's everything, it is open. So you yourself, you are going to give your details, so which you feel it is not so much a worrying fact. But still, we are going to give the data to them directly or indirectly, and that data, it is going to be sold to the marketers. So it's not being sold, it is like they are going to just give a information to the marketers so that they can be able to get a sales. And for that, they are going to charge it for this or for their marketers. Okay, so this is the advantage. So what you are going to get it as a marketer. So these people already have a data, so that we can be able to make use of it. Now we should think like a business people. So we can make use of these platforms, how we can be able to promote our product, how do we bring our information to the people. So when you are going to create an account, so initially when you are going to create it, that is called as a personal profile account. Okay, so personal information, what you are going to give it, it is called as a profile account. Whereas in the same profile, you can be able to create a business account. So it is mandatory that you should have a personal profile, and then only it will allow you to create a business account, because it wants to check it out. Facebook before, it was not having so much of kind of verification that whether this person is genuine or not. So for that reason, it was been given with full power to the audiences, so that they can create as many accounts they wanted. But nowadays, it has become very much strict with the verification process. They are going to verify it, that is it genuinely it's a human being, and whether the details what they were provided, is it right? So all those things, it will be verified, and then only they are going to accept with that account process. Okay, so the next thing is, once you are going to create a personal profile and it sees the activities, and it is going to allow you to create a business account. So what is the difference between the personal profile and the business account is, when you are going to use the personal profile, you can be able to get connected to the known people, and whatever the information you share it, that we call it as a postings. So that post, it will reach to only to your known people. So you can be able to share it within the known people. Whereas when you are going to do the same process on the business account, it can be reached to any unknown people also, that is your audience. And if you are going to pay the money and advertise it, or the other word is promoting, so if you do the promotion, and it will be not at a free of cost, it has to be paid. So when you are doing a promotion, you are going to be reaching out your information who is nowhere connected to your business page, sorry, for your personal profile, and still you can be able to get that person as a customer. Okay, so this is the main difference between the personal profile and the business account. Let's see how we can be able to create a business account. So before going to that, let me ask you people, how many of them, they does not have a Facebook account? Good. So thank you for the responses. So it could be a personal reasons why you people does not want to use the Facebook account. As I said, if you want to open a Facebook business profile, it's mandatory that you should have a personal profile account. Okay, so it is up to you people how you are going to create with that, and how fast you are going to create with a business account, and you can make use of it. And definitely Facebook, Instagram, these are all the places where you can be able to get more audiences comparatively to any other business platforms. So the B2C customers are more over here comparatively. Okay, so Instagram account, now I think most of you know or doesn't know, Instagram has been taken over by the Facebook people and even the WhatsApp also. So there is a chances that you can be able to link with your Instagram account with Facebook account. So you can link both, and whatever the post you are going to post it on the Facebook or on the Instagram, it will be posted on the other side automatically. And when you do the promotion, you can also do the promotion at both the end. Okay, you can interlink your Facebook account with your Instagram account. Okay, so fine. So the people who does not have it, so it is up to you people how you are going to manage with. Let's have a look how we can be able to create with the Facebook My Business. So this is how the personal profile account will be look like. So let me enter with my password. Okay, it is taking some time. Kindly bear a minute. So this is the personal profile, what it is going to be created. Now, if you want to create a business page, so on the left hand side, you can see under the pages. So what all the companies you have been created, it is going to show over here under this. So either you can go to the pages and you can create a new page, or for the first time users who are not been seen, who doesn't have the pages option. So you can click on this menu bar option. So under the create option, you can be able to select with page. So here the business, it is going to be shown in the name as page. So now let me create with the page name. I've added my company name. Add with the category which are applicable. I can be able to add it up to three types of categories. The next, give the description. Okay, so let me not take much time on this. So up to 255 characters are limitation. Click on create page. So once after clicking on create page, so you will be asked to select with the profile picture and the cover image. So if you have already created, you can be able to upload it. Then you can be able to add a cover photo. So when you are going to add the cover photo, please have a look. The size, the width of it, it is completely different. Comparatively to the normal pictures. So in Canva.com, we have an option as Facebook cover option, which is going to create you the image as per the resolutions minimum required. Okay, what happens if you are going to just use an image, normal image over there? So it will be like a blur image, it will be there. So the clarity of it, it will be not be so good, because the cover page, the profile picture, it is going to be like a welcome to a business page. So please be very much sure and clear that you are going to have a cover image as well as profile picture. Even though if you does not have it, then it will be a problem. Even if you are going to have it, but it is not so designed, or it is not so clarity on the business, then people will not show the interest. The visibility of it will be very less comparatively. So which we can call it as a social media optimization. So the optimization, it will not be increased over there. Okay, so let me select it. So whichever the relevant template. Okay, let me take this. I think this would be a relevant one. Okay, so let me download this in a JPEG format. Okay, let me add this. Add cover photo. So this are we can be able to show our cover image. Okay, so make sure that you are going to position your cover photo in proper way so that whatever you want to highlighted about your business, so you can be able to position it in a proper way. So you can see it is, you can be able to move it around. So where exactly you want to show it, click on save. So it is asking you to connect with the WhatsApp. So as of now, let's not connect with the WhatsApp. You can connect it whenever you want it. You have an option over there. So the next thing is, you have been added with your profile picture cover image. So you should talk about your business. So if anyone comes and check it out, who are you? So what is that you are going to provide it? So on which are the places you have the services. So if you want to give a bio of your business, so where do we give it? Means we have to go for option called on the left hand side. If you scroll down, edit page info, you can go to this option and you can be able to give the information. So username, it will be a short name or the name which you want to identify. Suppose if anyone is going to tag you with any of the posts, so they will be using the @, like how we have a hashtags. So same way, so when you are going to connect with, when your business page has to be connected, with what name it has to be connected. So either you can use your own business names, or it could be any identical identical names. Okay, so let me give it my business name as my business identity or the username, and make sure that when you click outside anywhere, it says that the username, it has already been taken. So let me take it as Digital Raj Agency. Let me check it out. No, so this name has not been registered by anyone else. So it is allowed to me to use it as a username. Now the next thing is description. You can be able to provide your description of your business. So my request is try to have it minimum 200 characters to 300 characters as your business description. Okay, so it will always get an identity. So the more words you are going to add it, there will be some keywords which can connect your business page in faster way. The visibility will be more on these cases. Okay, so then category, if you are going to have other category also involved in it, that is, if you are doing a business with multiple categories, you can be able to select it, but here it is allowed only up to 3. Okay, so try to select the category which is relevant to your business. Okay, the next thing is contact number. Suppose if you do not want to share your contact details and it should not be public, okay, so if you don't give it, it will say that your profile is incomplete. Suppose if you want to complete the profile without giving the contact details, in such instances you can see under every contact detail there is an option called my page does not have a phone number. So that means I am not ready to give the phone number. So I can tick on this so that it will not say that it is a blank. So it is filled up. Okay. The next thing is, do you have a WhatsApp phone number to get connected? No, as of now, no. Okay, so it's not allowing it because again the commercial, when you are going to create an ad, so it has to be given with the contact number. And the first and foremost, the easiest way to get connected with the people, it is going to be a WhatsApp. So it is not allowing us to make it not applicable. So the next thing is email address. I think we don't have any issues when we are going to give with our email ID. The next, if you have a website, you can be able to give it. Suppose if you want to promote your business website, so you can be able to give with that. Okay, so we have been given with our website address also. So you can be able to link between one account to another digital platform account so that it will be easy for your traffic will be driven from one account to another account and there will be more visibility of all the platforms. Okay, so the next thing is address. So do you want to specify the address? If it is an online address, sorry, online business, you can give your home location only. If it is specifically, if you have any shop or anything, you can be able to give that particular address. But there should be one particular location, so where the point of contact should be there. Okay, so let me give it, for example, Jayanagar. And you can be able to drag and drop it where exactly the location it is available. And if you do not want to share it, you can be able to click on this. Okay, so try to not to click with this so that it will be understood that there is some business happening on this particular place. Okay, so let's not go much on the location wise. The next very important thing is service areas. So are you going to give the services to all over the Karnataka or outside Karnataka, that is different states, or is it with the different countries, or is it with the different areas within Karnataka or within Bangalore? So you can be able to add the areas. So you can see the list over here, it is showing all the city names inside the state. You can also add it with the areas also. Okay, so it is up to your business type. So let me take it. I'm ready to give the services to all over the Karnataka audiences. The next, what is your working hours? So you can be able to select with all the relevant option. I can specify that what time I am available with. So I am available at from 8 to 2. So it is 24-hour format. You can be able to give it. Or if you want, you can be able to give it with 12-hour format only. So I think this better to give with 24-hour format. Yeah. So like this, you can give it for all the days. So whatever the timing you are specifying, so you can be able to specify with same time available. In case if you want to have a break in between, I think we have seen in the Google My Business, you can be able to click on this add button and you can be able to split the timings. Okay. Fine. So let's assume it that Sunday is not opened. The next, in case of any changes in between, temporary service changes, you can be able to select with the relevant option. So let me select with operating as usual. The next very important thing is privacy policies. If you have any terms and conditions, you can be able to add it over here in the privacy policies, or you can be able to link with any of the websites where it has been provided with privacy policies. Okay. So the next thing is impressum. This information should not be provided by us. So it is only specific countries who are from Austria, Germany, and Switzerland. So these people, when they are going to record the information about their business, it's mandatory, it's their government rule. So they have to provide some kind of important informations about their what do you call it as the registration of their business details has to be provided. Okay. The next thing is, do you want to talk about any specific products over here? You can be able to specify here. And in case, is there any specific or any kind of offers, or it could be any new product informations you want to say that it is going to be launched, anything extra information you want to share it with your audience, you can add it over here in the additional information. Okay. So the next, in the price range, let it be as unspecified. So here, okay, received a message. Privacy policy, okay. Okay, example, like if you are going to say that no exchange or no returns are accepted. Once the goods are sold, you are not going to be take it returns. Or there is only guarantee, there is no guarantee on the product. So any such kind of informations, if you want to add it, you can be able to add it in this privacy policy. So here it is asking you, if you have such policies, like if you are being created with any website, in that website, if you have this privacy policies, you can be able to give a link over there, or you can add those information manually in the additional information. Okay, thank you. So here, whenever you are going to add any information, and if you are going to click on other option, automatically it is going to get saved. So that is auto saving option, it is available. So there is no anything like click OK or save option, so that it is going to save all the details. Okay, so it is going to get saved with automatically. So these are the minimum basic business information to be given when you create a business page. Is that everyone are clear till here? Like, did you people came to know how to create a business page and how to add your business information? If you are clear, please type it as clear, or if you want to repeat it, you can click on you can type it as repeat. Or if you have any specific questions, you can be able to raise it at any moment. Okay, thank you for your responses. Now, after adding all your business information, so the next thing is, so you can click on home option so that it will take you to the home page. So every time, until and unless you are going to link with your WhatsApp account, it is not going to leave you, but I do not want to keep it connected with the WhatsApp as of now, so I've disconnected. Okay, so you can see that informations, whatever you have been given, it has been saved, and you can see an example that your username below your business name, the username also, it has been displaying over here. Okay, so if anyone is going to tag me, they have to use the @DigitalRajAgency. Okay, fine. So we have done the basic settings. The next part is, once the people are going to show some interest, how do they go ahead? How do they get connected with you? So there is an option next to your business name in the name as add a button. So click on add a button option so that you will be asked what kind of button do you want to give it to your audiences. So what is this button means? It is called as CTA. CTA button. So CTA stands for click to action. So that means if they are showing interest, how they can be able to get connected with us, how we can be able to get the business from them, and how we can be able to give our quotations or any informations related to our products. Okay, so what kind of action button do you want to give it to your audience? You might have seen that most of the people who are celebrities and influencers, so they are going to use a button called follow. So the more followers they are going to expect it. So if your business is something related that if you have more followers, okay, so you do you want to promote your videos or any of your posts, so you can be able to use the call to action button as follow. So if anything, it is like, yeah, you want the more followers to be there for your profile, then you can use with the follow option. Then next, you have different options based on your business types, you can be able to select with that. Okay, so my business is related to digital agency. So the people who are going to show the interest, so I want them to call me back. So I'll use the option called follow, and I can be able to give the contact number. Make sure that you are going to select with right pin, sorry, ISD code. So keep it in the right format and click on save. So now you can be able to see that it is going to show the call to action button as call now. So when you people are going to open my business page, you will be getting it option as call now. So once you are going to click on that, if you are using it through the mobile, I think you will be having an experience when you click on that button. It directly it will connect to your dialer pad. Okay, so you can be able to call up to that number directly from one click. Okay, so this is what you are going to give it to take the action when your audience are interested with your services. Okay, so the next thing is you can see there are different tabs are available over here, that is like home, services, reviews, shop, and many more options are available. So now can you just list me out which are those options is really needed to be on top? Is that my business is related to the service industry? So yes, services should be on top. And do I prefer it based on the reviews of my customers? I should have more business, or is it I want to offer more and based on that I want the more businesses? So which could be a right option? Is it based on the offer or based on the reviews? What could be a right option? Good. So by default it has selected with such a options, because there is an option on the left hand side. If you go to the settings, here there is an option called templates and tabs. So here I can be able to see that the current template which has been selected as services. So if you think that this is not a right template for your business, you can click on edit and you can find it lot of other options. But based on the information which I have already given at the time of creating a page, so Facebook is recommending that this is the right tab for you. Okay. So you have a lot of other options. You can just click on those. And if you are interested with this option, you can see if I have selected as business, then I would have got this options as the preferred options, groups, jobs, events like this. And if I want to use this, I can click on apply template. So the same template would have been applied. Okay, then below to it, you can see the tabs over here. So it is available. If you feel it, instead of shop, if I want to promote it with my works based on the photos or videos, see the photos, it is there. The tab is here at the fifth or sixth position. I just want to keep it on top. Means I can just drag this, hold it, drag it, and you can be able to drop it. Okay, so if you want to drop it on top, you can drop it over there. So like this, you can be able to reshuffle with all the tabs which you feel it. So at this moment, my works, it has to be shown. A new thing that is going to come. So So in that case, I'm going to add with more images. So in that cases, my photo should be highlighted, and the people who are interested to see my works, so they can be, they should be able to get a tab what I want to portray. So that tab should be there on the top. You can change it at any moment. Okay, so you can be able to change like this. And if you see any option which is not been highlighted, that means that option is not applicable for that particular type of template. So if you really want, you can be able to click on this and you can enable that option. Okay, so now if you want to come back on the left hand side, above the page settings, you can see that company name. It shows, click on that name, it takes you to the home page. Do not click on this home page, that is home button, which is there on the top. So do not click on this home button. It will take you to the personal profile home page. Okay, so can you see that option what we have been changed it? We have reshuffled. So that option, it is going to be shown on the top. Okay, so you can rearrange it whenever you want it. Hope this was helpful for you people. Okay, so the next thing is, what will be the next important thing? So when you are going to handle this page, it is always required that you should be active. That is like you should be keep on adding the content to your business page. Either you should post it, or you should be able to comment it on the reviews or the responses what you are going to get it, the replies. And you should be able to like with the other posts, and you should do the activities and keep an eye on how the performance of your business page is happening. Okay, so to check that, you have a report option on the left hand side as insights. So most of the digital platforms which you want to check with the report, it will be in the name as insights only. So you can go to that report and you can be able to see the graphical representations. So what all the things, information, we can be able to gather it on this page, you can be able to see over here. Okay, so this will help you out to know that how your business page is performing. Okay. So if you find it any difficulty in handling this and you want to recruit a person who can be able to take care of this particular business page, handling it in a proper way and responding to all the posts, whatever the comments you are going to receive it. So on all those things, if you want to recruit a person, or you want to give a permission to a person to act actively take care of this particular business page, then you can go to the settings option. That is by going to the main page, by clicking on the business name. And click on settings option. So on the left hand side, there is an option called page roles. So you can click on the page roles option. So in this, you can be able to select over here the person's name or email ID. Okay. So one rule is that person who is going to be considered as your person who takes care of your business page should be a friend of your account. So that person should be a member of your account. So make sure that the person is a friend of your personal profile as well as your professional profile. If not with your personal profile also, it's okay. there should be a member of your business profile. Okay, so that person's name should be here, and you can see that there is an option called editor. So apart from editor, you have lot of other option can be selected. These are all the role what you are supposed to give it to your whoever the caretakers you are going to give the permission. So if you are going to select it as admin, so that person will have all the access whatever you are doing it as an admin, so all the access will be provided to that person. The next thing is editor. So that person will be allowed to edit it but not to delete it, and that person cannot be allowed to create another user, whereas admin can be able to create it. The next thing is moderator. So the person who is going to have an eye on all those comments, the contents what it is being shared on your business page. So if you find it something fishy, something abusing words or comments or any content, so you can be able to remove those contents from your business pages. The next thing is advertiser. So the person who will be given the permission to create the promotions on the business page, so that person will be allowed only for promoting the business page and its content. The next thing is analyst. Only the person who is going to have a look of all the performance what it is going on and report it to the admin. Okay, so these are the rules which has been provided by the admin to the new user or the new role. Once you are going to add that person, so an invitation will be sent to that person. If that person accepts it, you can see, if you scroll down the page, you can see that person is going to be shown below the name of that admin, and it will show the role what they are going to handle with. Is that clear till here to everyone? So is there any doubt? Okay, so the next topic, it will be on this. So my request was, is that everyone are clear till here whatever we have been discussed? Yes, we can be able to, because since we are an admin, so we can be able to change the role to that person. Is that clear, Maria? Okay, thank you. Fine. So as per the request of Kausar Begum, so is it possible to link between the Instagram account and the Facebook account? Yes, it's possible. So you can see on the left hand side, there is an option called Instagram. So I can click on this. You can see that a connect account option is available. Okay, so I can click on this and I can connect it. But it is mandatory that you are supposed to have a business account on your Instagram account. So do you people are aware there is a personal profile account separately and the business profile account separately? Is there any person who is handling with business account in this room on Instagram? So if you people, you have it, I think this is the right place. At least you can have some followers over here. So you can share your Instagram handle account details over here. So this means no one is having a Instagram business account. So if you have, you can be able to share with that account so that you can get some more followers from this group. Okay, that's fine, no problem. So how do you link with your Instagram account with your Facebook account? Means the first and foremost thing is you should have a Instagram business account. So how do you identify that your Instagram, is it an personal account or is it an business account? So when you are going to click on your account name, it will take you to the settings. Okay, so there you will be having an option called edit profile. Okay, so with that edit profile, if you are getting an option as promote, so if you people are able to check it out, you can check it out. So please give me a minute of time, I'll just be back. Sorry for the inconvenience. Fine. So we were talking about, okay, that's good, man. Kausar Fashions. So people who are there in this floor, please support Kausar and please follow her and give some businesses and also refer it. Okay, all the best, Kausar. Fine. Okay, that's good. So how we can be able to identify? So as we know that when you are going to have a settings option, when you go, you'll be having an option with your edit profile option. Next to that, if the word promoted is there, then it is considered as an business account. How you can be able to turn out a personal profile account into business account means, my suggestion is do not use your personal profile as a business account. Rather than that, if you are very much sure, yes, I want to use it for both personal as well as a personal and business, you can be able to use it. Otherwise, try to create a new account, and after creating a new account, go to the edit profile option or you go to settings option. There you will have an option in the account center as at the bottom of the screen as add a professional account. So if you click on add a professional account, a separate account it will be generated for the business purpose. If you go to the edit profile or in the settings account center itself, and if you are going to make it personal account into switch to professional, there will be one account which will be turned personal into business account, which is not recommended for you people. Okay, so you can have separately. So you click on add to professional account. Okay, so once you create the professional account, it is all self-explanatory. You can be able to go ahead with all the informations related to your business. It will ask about the category of the business, contact mail ID and number, and also it will be asking with your what kind of followers do you follow with. So all this basic information, it will be self-explanatory. You can be able to create it. Then you should go to the edit profile option, especially Kausar. So you can go to the edit profile option in the business account. There you will be having an option to page to connect. So are you trying it now itself, Kausar? Is that Kausar Begum is online? Yeah. So if you go to the edit profile option, there you will be having the name, biography, what is your website address, and then finally you have it as a page to connect. There, if you are going to click over there, it will ask you to connect with your Facebook account. And do you want to connect with the existing business page or with the new business page? So if you have already created a business page on the Facebook, then you can select it as existing business page. If you are not created with the Facebook business page, then you can click on new business page. So it will ask you to create again to do all this process, and then you can be able to connect with. Okay, so once it is going to be connected over there, then you can come to the Facebook over here in the settings, Instagram, and click on connect account. Then it will be, both will be connected together. Okay, so try with this all these options. So who are already having a business account and who wants to connect it with Facebook, please open a Facebook account, create a business page, and you can be able to go ahead with this. So if you are not going to create the Facebook account or you are not going to create a business page, then you can be able to use it only with the Instagram. And Instagram, it is only comfortable, and it is only the feature it is being used on the mobile version, whereas Facebook, it is both desktop and mobile, both it will be available. Okay, so try to create a new business account on your Facebook, and if you people are not using it, you can ask your other friends also who is having their Facebook account if they are ready to give their credentials. So you can take the credentials of theirs and you can create the business page separately. Okay, so that is one kind of facility is being provided by the Facebook. So you can create n number of business pages you want it. Okay. So try to create with this, and we'll meet in the next class with how to create the different types of posts on the business page. Okay. So is that everyone are clear till here? If you have any doubt, you can raise the doubt so that we can clear it. Or do you want me to repeat it once again with the overview of how to create with the business page? Okay. Is that only Kausar Begum is active? Okay, thank you, others also. Fine then, so we'll meet tomorrow at same time, 4:30. And we will be continuing the Facebook marketing. We will see how to create the different kinds of posts and how we can be able to promote the same through the Facebook. Okay, thank you all. Have a wonderful day.